Nigga!
Of the ghetto, ain't no escaping cause I'm way too young. Pops is dealing, and on top of that, got mom sprung. Scheming off the top, pops never figured that he go down by the hands of another nigga. Now my pops is gone, and that ain't no good. Got to follow in the footsteps of the homies from the hood. And as the role model, niggas put me in my fucking baby bottle. Damn, and through all the motherfucking pain, they done drove my mom's insane. So I guess I gotta do work, so I ain't finished. I go work the fuck straight up minutes.
A coach hopes to help his player get more out of his plate appearances. Now I'm of age and living in the projects, getting paid off the clubs and the county checks. I'm telling you, fresh out of high school, never did I wonder that the motherfucking hood would take me under. Gee, I'm kicking it with the homies and they got the straps off to the corner store owned by the fucking see a bitch in the right lane, so I comes with the Mac. Astro Van pulls a motherfucking jack from the back. Now he's got the strap to my homie's head, saying play this shit cool and don't be a fool. He shot my head.
There is rain in the area, but we've been given the go-ahead to get this one started. Tonight, a battle of two first-place squads between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Cleveland Indians. The Cards aim to notch their seventh win in a row right after this. Tommy Wilson, a California-born right-hander, is on the mound. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, you can't always judge a pitcher by the numbers. I know the ERA is into the fours coming into this start, but he's actually a pretty solid pitcher. And every once in a while, he can throw some decent games in there. It's not easy having an ERA under four in baseball. He's slightly over that, but this guy's a better pitcher than that ERA indicates.
So now into the box is Mario Terrell. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. First offering. Underway here in the Monday opener as the game's first pitch misses for ball one. Fellas, we check out the Tribe as they begin here tonight. Well, they've been on a pretty good roll of late, winners of seven of their last eight ball games.
Yeah, Matty, you never know right here. Interleague game, when the weather gets cold, this could be a nice harbinger to what we're going to see in the Fall Classic right here. Two first-place teams going to lock horns in a battle, and I'm jacked up.
Zimmer has to roam straight back, but he has it for the first down. And that will bring in the former top prospect, Amed Rosario. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Wind up and the 0-1. Lifted into center field. Terrell is there and he has it for the first down. So now here is Mario Terrell looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. First pitch of the AB now.
Nope, outside.
Terrell is really a well-balanced hitter. That doesn't seem to matter whether he's facing a right-hander or a lefty. He makes a lot of loud contact either way, which is quite rare in today's game.
Yeah, you can tell this guy really pays attention, puts time in the cage, studies the video, seems to always have a game plan, and is not off balance too much. The offense better get it going right here because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
Perfect.
The
in now for Cleveland, Nolan Jones. And with numbers like those, he's putting himself in contention for some Rookie of the Year hardware if he can keep it up.
You know, these next couple innings are really important for these guys. I know they're only down by a couple, but they need to get something going on offense to keep pace, even though it's early.
In to center field, line drive, base hit.
No runner,
opening single kicks off their half of the third. Well, when you're going as well as he is, not even a two-strike count is going to get in your way.
Yeah, Matty, he's having a monster season, well over 300. Right there, when you're feeling that confident at the plate, it doesn't matter what the count is.
Back to the top of the order now, and up next will be the shortstop, Amed Rosario. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Now this is driven out to deep right center. This could be trouble, and it is trouble. It finds the gap for extra bases. As he arrives at second without a play, as they also push across a score to make it a one-run game. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance. And he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second, and his buddy is high-fiving teammates in the dugout.
Next to stand in is Mario Terrell. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch-outs will stick with you a little longer.
Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. Really starting to pour now, and the forecast is not showing any signs of a break in the weather.
Total agreement, Matt, in particular that pitcher's mound. You know, one of the things you have to really be careful, not just for the position players, but that mound gets awfully slippery and awfully wet when it becomes moist like it is right now. So the umpires are going to have to really pay attention to the conditions on the field.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three-ball count.
The 3-1 pitch. And he takes ball four, so he's on. And as you know, that often means the steal could be in order here.
You know, it takes a lot of discipline to watch a pitch like that go by, but on a 3-1 count, he had the luxury of being a little bit more selective up there. Good take, and a walk is the result.
J.D. Davis, the next at bat. Last time up, he was hit by a pitch. Ready with the 2-0 pitch. Pitch misses the throwdown. Well behind the play, that's an easy stolen base. So now to the plate, J.D. Davis.
Now batting, the designated hitter, J.D.
The 0-2 pitch. Here's a little chopper up the middle. In time to first, and there are two away. So a man at third here with two gone. And in next, it'll be the perennial MVP candidate, third baseman Nolan Arenado. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Bouncer up the middle. Scooped up. Over to first, and that retires the side. One left for the Cardinals, and it's still 3-1. So two out, nobody on. And up next, the San Diego area native, Bradley Zimmer. Wind up, and the 0-1. High fly ball out to straightaway center. terrible. Find some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Clearly enjoying their time here at the ballpark, as are we. Back with more on this Monday night after this. On its way. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Good one up there, huh?
Hey, guys, that fastball just registered 97 miles an hour. On a night like tonight, where it's super cold out, if you don't get to head to that baseball right there and you get jammed, it's almost like getting stung by a pack of wasps.
Hey, what time? Right now.
This is in the air out to straightaway center. Waiting on it is Zimmer, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Ryan McMahon digs in to bat next.
Ryan McMahon.
In the air out to center field. Terrell is right there, one down. Andrés Giménez the next to bat. Flew out last time up. Here comes the 1-2. Hit in the air to straightaway center. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Down in order go the Tribe. Score holds, it's 3-1. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch, and it's fouled away. Three runs already home here.
Ball
one as he lays off below the zone. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot he's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Hey, have a rip at it up there, huh?
The 2-1 home.
Down to 3-1.
Two on, two out with a base open here as a pitcher. You have to be awful careful. You just don't want to groove something here and give this guy a pitch that he can hit one out of the park on.
Popped him up. Naylor has a play. He handles it easily, and the inning is over. So three runs on three hits, no errors, and two left. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. The Cardinals lead it 6-1.
Winners of an amazing 7 games in a row. They say to never question the streak, and these guys aren't. They're just enjoying this ride.
And tonight's ends at a 6-2 finish. The St. Louis Cardinals crossed the plate 3 times in the 8th, helping propel them to the win. Trevor Williams earns win number 7 on the season. Jack Sanchez gets a 4-out save, his first of the year. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter, at MLB The Show.
Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 3 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at Progressive Field, 35,041. The Indians thank you for your continued support and remind you to please drive home safely. Thank you and good night.
Time baseball now from Progressive Field here in the Buckeye State of Ohio. Tonight, it's a compelling matchup of two division leaders between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Cleveland Indians. The Redbirds are looking to collect their 8th win in a row next. Carlos Vargas gets the ball for the Indians in this one. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, Matty V, this ought to be exciting. This is one of the top young pitchers in the game right now. He keeps getting better. He keeps learning. And if he continues at this pace, this guy has a chance to be one of the more reliable pitchers in the game.
And now in the box, Mario Terrell. And we are set for baseball here this evening.
The center fielder, number 21.
Come on, big dog, get your pitch.
Now the first pitch. High in the air out to center field. Waiting on it is Zimmer. One down.
Three.
Now into the box, Amed Rosario. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The designated hitter, Amed.
1-2. Lifted in the air to center field. Terrell is there and he has it for the first out. Bottom of the inning now. Here comes the first baseman, Ryan McMahon.
The first baseman, Ryan McMahon.
Into center field, line drive, base hit. So a productive start to the inning for the Tribe as their leadoff hitter is aboard.
Hey, this guy's been slumping at the plate. Saw his average fall below 240 prior to this at bat. That knock had to feel good.
Again is Mario Terrell. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest.
Terrell.
All right, come on now, one time, let it fly.
Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. High and tight here to begin the inning, it's ball one.
Hey, I need you right here, one time.
And that's right there, and we're even at one. One misses for the second ball.
Two balls.
Put
one string
on it. Here we go.
Hit out towards second. And that'll get on through into center field, so he's got himself a leadoff single.
That'll
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dan. Sent it back right where it came from.
The Next up is Jake Cronenworth, looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. Throw over to the bag. Oh, and he throws him, and they got him.
So much for that leadoff single. That was a good move and a pretty quick tag by the first baseman, and it's like the hit never even happened.
On its way. Oh, missed that one by a mile. It's 0-1.
I mean, that's a classic case of coming off your backside right there. He lost his entire back leg, was out in front, couldn't keep his hands back.
Outside for a ball, 1-1. Two balls and a strike to the St. Louis leadoff hitter. The 2-1.
Come on, let it rip right here.
And a slider. Oh, got a favorable call on that one as that's the first out of the inning.
Well, no preferential treatment there. Sometimes we see great hitters have their calls go their way on close pitches, but not this time. I think that was actually a good take, but on two strikes, anything that close.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please.
Into the box now, Mario Terrell. He sends it on the ground softly to the left. On the first, and how important is it to keep this guy off base in a time?
Ball four, thanks for that. Three, ball four, thanks for that.
Next, here is Mario Terrell, grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
Hey, right guy, right place. Nobody better.
From the stretch.
There are a couple of points in every game that could decide winning or losing. This is one of those critical spots. Time to make some great pitches.
Bader at second. Barrera at first. One gone.
Here we go.
All right,
hang on, hang
nice
on.
Hit.
Right here, right
Throw
here.
Comes in quickly here, so that'll hold that go-ahead run at third back. Now with still only one away.
Yeah, the pitching coach takes the stroll out to the mound, and with a pitcher this young, you just want to let him know that he's out there for a reason and to trust what got him here is good enough to get him through this.
Jake Cronenworth. Bases are loaded here, one man out. Oh, this is hit to third. Will it be?
Get dirty.
Mingles at second. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. Just what the doctor ordered. He gets the double play to get him out of the inning. Don't go anywhere. More Tuesday Night Baseball after this. Jimenez the next to bat. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. The 0-2. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Racing back to center fielder. And just short of a home run, this ball's off the wall. And your go-ahead run is in there at second base as he's got himself a two-out double.
Wow, he was willing that thing to get out of here. Would have given them the lead right here late in the game, but it ends up hitting off the wall, and he heads into second with an extra base hit. We'll see if the next man up can come.
And that'll bring in Fran Reyes. A two-out hit and win it. Past Waller, wild pitch would do the trick just as well. High in the air out to center field. Terrell is there now to put this one away for the third out as they'll strand that potential go-ahead run at third base. Indians strand a couple. Still tied 3-3. Singled in his last at-bat.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield, he's going to wave them.
Now the first pitch. A little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first.
This has to be a productive at-bat right here. I know you want to drive the run in and get the RBI, but you have to find a way, bare minimum, to move this runner over to third.
Now a changeup in on the hands that evens it at 1-1. Now some movement in the Tribe bullpen as a right-hander starts to loosen up.
Speed up and drive it, huh?
Hit the other way out toward right field. Long run for the right fielder. He makes the play. Runner
all right,
tags
hold on right
third.
Here.
And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away.
Three.
Hey, it took them an extra frame to do it, but hey, they're not going to fight as they lock up a nice road victory here in 10 innings.
And this evening's contest comes to a close, 5-3 the final. The Cardinals with a big 17-hit attack. Joe Jimenez claims the win out of the pen, his first. Giovanni Gallegos records the save, his 11th of the campaign. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
For Cleveland, 3 runs on 9 hits, 1 error. They left 17 runners on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 4 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at Progressive Field, 35,041. The Indians thank you for your continued support and remind you to please drive home safely. Thank you and good night.
We've got baseball for you this afternoon from Progressive Field in downtown Cleveland. Today, a matchup of a pair of first-place teams between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Cleveland Indians. The Cards are riding an 8-game win streak. They'll try to run it to 9 next. Shane Bieber starts the game on the mound for the third and final game of the series. Dan, any thoughts?
Well, this guy's kind of unique. How about a 5-pitch repertoire that he has that gives him a lot of options for both righties and lefties? And if he's on, he could be really tough to hit.
So stepping in is Mario Terrell. He will lead this one off today.
Right here, one time, let's go.
The center fielder, number 21.
Hey, get your pitch up there.
Now here's the first offering.
strike.
And he starts him out with a strike on the outer half. So, fellas, this Indians ball club, as they begin play here this afternoon, they come in playing reasonably well of late, though they have dropped their last two in a row.
Yeah, Matty B. Hey, D-Row, this has not been the kind of homestand that they would like to have so far. Through the first five games, they're 2-3. D-Row, getting to 500 on this homestand is certainly one thing they'd like to do here today.
Yeah, they can salvage a little bit right now. They can walk out of here today with a smile on their face if they can get this back to 500 in these first six games.
The 0-2 delivery. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the leadoff man is gone to open up the ball game.
This is what a power pitcher will do to you if he executes his pitches. That was a three-pitch strikeout, and with the kind of stuff that he has, it's not uncommon for him to absolutely dominate certain guys.
So next to hit is Bo Naylor, and he's hoping to get things going at the plate. It's been a bit of a struggle for him in recent games.
All right, here we go now.
This is skied into the air to straightaway center. Is there as he makes the catch, and they'll tightrope out of danger as he strands the bases loaded. A couple of walks, but no damage. More matinee baseball here on a Wednesday afternoon following this. Last trip to the plate.
And he can't allow the same thing to happen in this situation. This is a big time spot in this game. He's got to find a way to put the ball in play.
Hey, get your pitch up there, kid. Let's go now.
First pitch on the way. Soft liner to the left side.
Find the ball, find the ball, find the ball.
And the run is in to score from third. It's a 2-0 ball game. Throw won't be in time as he reaches it first. And now time will be called here as you see the pitching coach making his way out to the mound to pay a quick visit. So next to bat will be Jake Cronenworth. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, in today's game, certainly don't get completely reprimanded for too many strikeouts, but no one likes to go down looking. We expect him to be a little bit more aggressive at the dish this AB.
Here we go, here we go.
Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
Really impressive pitching right there. Sometimes as a pitcher, you can get frustrated when you make a good pitch and you don't get that call from the umpire. But what does he do? He comes back with a good pitch and gets the strike.
So one gone here in the St. Louis third, and that'll bring in Nolan Arenado.
Hey, come on now.
Now the first pitch. Pitch inside, the throw. He's in there easily as the throw bounces on the way down.
This catcher has an elite arm. But when you get that great of a jump at first base, it makes it a lot easier to steal second.
Digging in next, Nolan Arenado. Carroll, the runner at second with one away.
Hey, have a rip up there right now, huh?
And this is swung on and missed. His fifth strikeout already, and there are two gone in the inning.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Him up.
Go, 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 go.
Hernandez is under it. No problem with this one, and the inning is over. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left on. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. The Cardinals are out in front, 2-0.
Ball four, take the base.
Three!
Digging in will be Mario Terrell. He's one for two in the ballgame.
Let's go, kid. Mario Terrell.
Hey, you got it. No one better. Let's go.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Boy,
hey, Dero, that's just what you want to do. Keep the pressure on. He's given up a couple of runs early already in this game, and now he gives up the two-out single.
Yeah, no chance right there. You want to make this guy work. You want to try and get into that pen as quick as possible. And if two-out knocks are the answer, so be it.
And at the plate is Jake Cronenworth. He's gone down on strikes twice already in this one. And Dan, when you know you have a chance to hand someone a hat trick for the game, is there any extra motivation to punch him out again?
Hey, there's no doubt about that, Matt. When you have a good hitter like this and you've punched him out twice already, you just want to continue.
And they get him trying to swipe a base to retire the side. Trying to move into scoring position with two away, but not to be as we get another look. More matinee baseball here on a Wednesday afternoon following this.
Out, three, he's out. Out, good, three, two, three, out.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go Mario Terrell. Two hits and three at-bats for him in this one. Here's the first pitch.
Ball, that's out.
Now the 1-0 is looked at for the first strike.
Ooh, that was some gas. Triple digits on the radar gun.
Bounce it to the left side. Gonna be a tough
play. Go hard.
High throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they clear the out.
Four, take your base.
Your attention, please.
Next to hit, Jordan Luplo. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Sent out to straightaway center field. Catch made in center. Here comes the runner from third.
Relay four.
And a relay to the plate. And this will go down as a sack fly and an RBI as it's now a 4-2 game.
Every team is looking for that insurance run late in the game. That run right there gives them a 2-run lead heading into the late innings. Board, keep pitching, and defense in certain spots. This one was a fun one to watch.
4-2, the final score today. The Cleveland Indians came through late, taking the lead in the eighth to secure the victory. Emmanuel Clase earns his third win of the year in relief. James Karinchak closes the door for the save, his 22nd. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
They left six men on base.
Don't you open up that window. Don't you let out that antidote. Yeah. Popping pills is all we know. Inhales is all we know. Don't go through the front door. It's low key at the night show. So don't you open up that window. Don't you let out that antidote. Yeah. Party on a Sunday.
ball shit. I just hit a